What's up, guys? Back again. So again, we're still on square one, trying to figure out, see what's going on with the Celica. I am doing some testing here on some of the sensors, as well as the wiring that goes from the PCM, or the ECM, power control module, back to the wiring to the sensors. So crank sensor, I got the 5 volts, ground is good, and I got my 12 volts coming in. Same with the cam position sensors, same reading. I am testing everything else out, which is showing it has power and signal to it. So I am wondering if it could be something else going on. So, and I'll show you how I'm doing some of the testing here on the wiring, the readings I'm getting, what we'll get together, and we'll see if we can figure this thing out. I am going to try and ground some other things out. Like I said in the last video, the battery did go kapoop. So I just am going to see if I can just charge the old one back up and see if it will crank back over, or maybe I might need to remove the starter, because unless if that's also hung up on the flywheel. I'm not sure what's going on yet, but we'll do it all together, guys. All right, guys, so let's go ahead and let's do this test together here. Basically what we have to do, these two wires again are basically the signal sends to the PCM. So it's kind of like when you turn your key, it basically allows power to go to the computer. So that's what these two are. And I got them held on with this here, just so it's kind of attached to the positive side. And what we're going to do is actually put some pins and test this crank sensor in the wiring to make sure it's getting its voltage, its signal, and its ground properly sent to the sensor. So what we have to do is attach the ground. You're going to hear it click as the relays are going to switch over, and then from there we could test I believe the yellow black. So if you look at it from the back end, the blue is going to be the 5 volt switch from the PCM, so that's where it's going to get its signal. The yellow black here is the 12 volt power, and the brown yellow is the ground. So I just put the ground on. These two again are touching now. You can hear it click. I kind of move them around. You hear the relay click on the inside. Let's go and check and test here. I got a multimeter, which I have right here. I'm going to go and set it to voltage. I'm going to put it on the 200 mark and to test it, just to make sure you can see the amount of voltage coming from the battery. You actually just put your leads on, one red for positive and black for ground, and that's going to tell you how much voltage the battery is going to have. So if you actually test the sensors, you can put your ground, which is going to be the black one, on the ground on the battery or on the body, and you can check. And what I'm going to use is a paper clip. The paper clip's going to allow me to get into where the pin is. And I'm going to touch the lead and see if I got voltage. Yellow black first. You can't see it on the meter, but it says 11.3 because the battery's weak. The blue wire I'm going to check next, which is going to be on this far side here. And that should be roughly around 4.5, maybe 5 volts. 4.8 volts, so I know I got good signal from the PCM. So this is going to tell me to start looking elsewhere. So the next step I'm going to do, because the trigger, or this information that gets sent to the sensor itself, it could either be one, a bad sensor, which are going to be these crank sensors up here, but I probably think it's going to be, because these were still good, I probably forgot to put something down here. So let's take this thing apart here. Take a look. Now, I already tested the ground, and I know the ground is good as well with the signal to the PCM, that it is grounding out properly. So I am going to, if I remember correctly, I don't even remember putting those triggers in the engine. So I bet you, if anything, because that's what sends the signal over to the crank sensor, which then sends a signal to the computer, to tell the spark plugs and the fuel to spray or ignite. So I'm going to start taking this thing apart here just to confirm that, and let's check together, guys. I don't see it in there. It's just the chain that I see, but I don't see the piece in there for the trigger. All right, so found the issue why it's probably not sparking. Not sure if you guys know what these are. Oh, she scared me. What you doing? Leave it. This is a trigger for the crank sensor. This allows it, as it spins inside the cylinder, Nala, as it spins, it actually picks up the magnet and sends the signal to create a spark. This is what I'm missing, guys. Calm down. All right, so what I actually gotta do, and what they would say about work, idiot, I gotta pull these bolts back off, along with these around the whole perimeter of the timing chain cover, along with the valve cover, just to put this in. So let me take this thing apart here. All right, so while I'm gonna work on this, I'm gonna have the battery start to charge. It's only at 17%, so that's how weak this battery gotten since I tried starting it. Here, if you kind of look, if you could see the chain, they don't have the triggers in there because I believe it's supposed to sit in front of the chain. So let me go look for that. One thing I really hate is doing work twice. Waste of time, but I gotta do it in order to see if this thing works. So let me go ahead and see if, let's pull this cover off together, guys. What this thing's gonna look like. I got all the bolts off. Now I just gotta pry this section off here, and then I gotta re-prep it. New Honda Bond. Waste of time, but gotta do what you gotta do. So this is what I end up doing. I end up using these plastic pry bars. Finally got this section popped here. Once I did, I was working it basically all the way down. Kind of see it moving now. That's gonna basically allow it to come off. Kind of see the crack there as it builds. And that should be able to allow it to open up here. Since everything's fresh, the Honda Bond's still new, it's still pretty sticky here. Let's get this thing off. There we are. Just don't know where to put this. So basically this keyway right here, it says out. It's supposed to be on the outside. You see that little notch right here? It's supposed to go right here where this little groove is. As long as you get those two correct, should be fine. That's what I was missing though, guys. This little piece. Now I basically gotta do is clean all the surface back up, the whole perimeter. Looks like I missed a couple other areas, like this here, as you can tell it's dark brown. This area here, that area there. Those are just contact points for the cover where it needs to be. And I just gotta clean this area off too, as well as the cover. Put it back together. So the tool of the day that I am gonna be using, fancy razor blade. When you clean the surface, you do wanna take your time, guys, making sure that you get it done so you don't have to do it twice. Just clean the surface off nicely, scrape it off, make sure it's nice and clean. Also, you could use a Scotch-Brite. the purple or maroon one. That should also get in the grooves and crevices to actually get the surface pretty clean on both sides. And we should be able to get this thing back together. Okay guys, so we got this area all cleaned up here. I just kind of put a little dab, not much, right there if you can see it. Built it all the way around the perimeter of the oil pan. And instead of putting it on the block here, I just put it on the cover. So you kind of see the bead of silicone. I like to keep it kind of like at a point, so as it gets torqued down, it'll actually squeeze out. So let's get this thing put on together, guys, and get this thing going. Battery's still dead. I want to go get the other one out of the Sequoia and put this one in. Swap it out. All right, guys, let's try this out. Got the battery hooked up. All right, it did fire up. That's good news. So at least I know that the wiring's good. Fuel's coming in. Actually, it ain't coming in. That's just a spray. But hey, it fired up. So case, guys, if you guys don't know why it doesn't work ever before, if you guys are ever doing a swap in or you guys rebuilt the motor, don't forget to put the triggers in. Anyways, guys, this is gonna go and end the video for today. I do got some other things coming up. I did get some stuff in the mail. And how I got it is very interesting. Actually, I won a contest with 1320 video regarding both of the cars. Along with that, I still need to drop the tank in the CRX, figure out what's going on with the fuel system there. And I also did get some suspension in for the Celica, but again, it's not designed for the Celica, so I do got to fab some stuff up for that to work out. So there's a lot of things I still got to, that will be coming up, guys, so stay tuned to the next one. Fired up. I am happy. Catch you guys on the next one.